getting the coffee. I said, Lord, I don't know him. He goes, but I do. So I walked over and said, young man, can I ask you something? Can I share with you something that God has just given me? And he goes, excuse me? What? I said, well, I see you're running from the Lord and you're headed into a drug deal. And if you go on that drug deal, you're going to probably lose your life. Actually, the Lord told me to tell you that you would, that it's serious with God in your life right now. You have a praying grandmother on her knees at this moment, and you have a wife that loves the Lord more than ever. She's on her knees right now, and it's moved the heart of God to bring an intersection to your life that you'll have to make a decision now. He said, my God, are you with the FBI? I said, y'all found me. I said, no, God found you. Prayer found you. He began to weep. I said, let's just cut through the chase. Looks pretty serious to me. How about let's pray? And he grabbed me his hand. We grabbed each other's hand. He just led him through a simple prayer of salvation. The man received Jesus. He said, I'm canceling my ticket. I'm not going to that drug deal. I'm headed to my little grandmother on up here in Arkansas, and I'm going to tell her there is a crazy man sent from God, no doubt from your prayers, and I'm a changed human.
I'll tell you what, there need to be more crazy men around. Don't go away. We're going to find out when Mark died and had a heavenly visitation. Be right back after this word.